one of the last official tasks performed by the Governor General, Lord de Lisle, before his departure from Australia, was to present the Queen's and regimental colours to 4th Battalion, the Royal Australian Regiment. At Adelaide Cricket Ground, the Governor General presented the battalion colours in a stirring ceremony which dates back to medieval times. The Governor General, with his daughter, the Honourable Anne Sidney, was welcomed by the regimental colonel, Colonel Morrow. The Governor General's standard is broken as Lord de Lisle takes the salute. The commanding officer of 4th Battalion, Lieutenant Colonel Thompson, invites the Governor General to inspect the parade. The custom of carrying colours has its origin in ancient times, when during battle, warring factions carrying flags bearing family badges or bearings to show possessions of commanders and to serve as rallying points. The drums of the battalion band are piled ready to receive the colours during their blessing and consecration by senior army chaplains. During his inspection of the battalion, Lord de Lisle discusses the use of patrol tracker dogs, which will be used in Malaysia by the unit later this year. Now, the colours are uncased for the first time, prior to being consecrated and blessed. Because of their historic and symbolic significance, colours, before being presented, are always consecrated and God's blessing sought. Inspection over, the battalion recites an oath of allegiance. The chaplains are called forward to bless the colours. A solemn but proud moment for the newly formed battalion. Church of England senior chaplain Lengthall consecrates the colours. Roman Catholic chaplain General Morgan blesses the colours, which are then sprinkled with holy water. Protestant denomination Chaplain General Cunningham lays his hands on the colours, blesses them, and performs the dedication. The colours are then carefully prepared for the Governor General's official presentation to the unit. General Lord de Lisle first presents the Queen's colour. Since 1751, regiments have been allowed two colours only, the Queen's or King's colour and the regimental colour. Although no longer carried into battle, the colours remain a symbol of the regiment, for on them are borne the battle honours granted in recognition of gallant deeds performed by its members. Today, the Queen's and regimental colours serve as a reminder to all members of a unit of their duty to their sovereign and their country. In his address to the unit, Lord de Lisle said, "It is a great honour to have been given the task of presenting to you your battalion's first colours, for which God's blessing has been asked." The presentation completed, the colours now join the battalion for the first time. Carrying its new colours, the battalion prepares to march past. The 4th Battalion has the distinction of being the first combat battalion of the Royal Australian Regiment to be formed on Australian soil. It was raised at Woodside Camp, South Australia, in 1964. A approaching the dais, the colors are lowered in salute. Lord de Lisle told the battalion, "Together, these colors represent your faith in God, your devotion to the Queen, whose uniform we are all proud to wear, your loyalty to Australia, of which she is sovereign, and your pride in your regiment and your battalion." The battalion now changes its marching pace to quick time. The regimental motto of the 4th Battalion is Duty First, and their regimental battle honours include Korea. The battalion has an alliance with Her Majesty's Irish Guards. Final salute to the Governor General, the new battalion advances in review order.